Honestly, what is Google playing at? Well, quite often I get comments from you asking that type of question. What is Google trying to do? Are there some type of secret agenda that Google has? Well, actually, with so many things I've picked up over the last few months about Google, I thought I'd share some of those things that kind of I've gained knowledge of, but I wonder whether you're aware of them too. So you could say these are like secrets that Google hasn't particularly written out or put on their website. These are almost like things that Google doesn't really want you to know about, but there's something that you could find out if you know where to look. And by knowing some of these things, it will give you an effect, an area where you can give yourself a boost against your competition. Now, finding ways to get ahead and beat your competition can be quite hard work sometimes. But when you're given a bit of direction, a bit of help, and you're aware of what Google's looking for, that can obviously give you an ultimate head start. But the purpose of me producing these Google Business Profile videos is really to try and help you get that head start. So if you see value in my video, make sure you give it a thumbs up. And if you haven't done so already, make sure you subscribe and click the alert button so you don't miss the next video. So with the recent change from Google My Business to Google Business Profile, there's been some changes as to how you access the menu. We're also going to look at how there are different alert colors that show you the importance that Google has on certain things within the back end. Did you know that some users have more authority when they do a review than others? I'm also going to expose some hidden categories and also loads of tips at the end as well that's going to help you grow your business. So there's been a dramatic change Google's just released this week, and I'm going to show you exactly where it is and how it could affect your traffic today. So the first thing we're going to look at is the new interface. You notice that the coffee shops appear here at the top after the results being found. So if you were appearing as the local coffee shop in the standard results, the organic results, you'd have to scroll down the page, and there we go, then you start appearing here. So this initially would have been the top of the page, and then with Google My Business or Google Business Profile coming along, it's then put all of this in front. And we've got the map here and then the top three map pack here. But look, if I do a search in New York for this, you notice now a very different layout. The map is now to the side, and you've then got the top three here. On that same page, you now get the organic local ranking coming up as well. And that's a fairer way, really. So what it's doing is it's using the top of the page to share the map with the Google My Business or the Google Business Profile top three, and also the organic, which is far more useful and fairer than just having it where you've got to scroll right down the page before you get to the top one. So I just thought that'd be an interesting one to note, that if you see an increase in your local organic traffic, it's because this new layout is being trialed, and hopefully I think they'll stick with this because it looks a lot better. Now, the second thing is, did you know that certain users hold more weight when they review things or when they update things on Google? So let me show you why this is and how you can find out more about this secret. Local guys will get certain points for doing various things, and then they get badges, and as you can see, they got various levels depending on how many points they receive. But in effect, they're given greater authority over what they do. So I'm a level 8 guide. So if I give a review to someone, it's going to have a stronger authority, particularly if it's in the area that I review. Google is building up, in effect, a reliance on certain local guides. So this is a type of thing that people don't realize, but actually getting a review from someone with a high ranking as a local guide is going to be far more beneficial than someone who's perhaps got no authority in Google. Now, another way in which you could say it's a bit of a secret really is to how to control the photos that Google uses to represent your business. Now, you can't say you've got total control over this, but this does seem to work quite well. And the trick is to go, so if you go to your Google My Business or Google Business Profile, and if you look at there, say for example here, I've got this photo that's showing, and I didn't like it, then how do I get this changed? Well, one of the simplest ways to get this to change is to go to your Google My Business website. So if you log into your Google Business Profile Manager, and under website, you've then got this free website which you can set up, and I've done videos on this before if you've not seen it. But the key thing is Google tends to take this section or this photo here, and 9 times out of 10, it takes it from the photo that you use here as your edit header photo. So this is the one where if I look at the free website, it's the one that shows here. So as long as it thinks that's a relevant website image, it will then use it. And if you wanted then to change or to, this is the trick really. If you want to change this image here, then you might need to wait 5 to 10 minutes, but go into here, select or drag a photo onto here, or select it from what you've got already. So say for instance, I wanted to do this, and that could be my new photo. And that then that image there would then appear here if Google accepts it and it's not rejected. And the next thing to consider is the fact that Google has different trust colors. Chris Palmer recently referred to this. I'll just show you what he was referring to. Red obviously is quite limited when it comes to pending your business. But he noticed that if you start adding things like what's new or events, you can get it up to orange. And then he also noticed that if you add the opening date and images, you can get it up to blue. And his purpose in this was just to show that these types of things can and are viewed by Google as improving on the trust, that it gives another signal to Google that the business is trustworthy. So the fact you have these different colors is implying that Google has an algorithm that knows how trustworthy your business is. So you can, to some degree, control the ability to have a pending business then be accepted by Google. How it works, it's still a bit of a secret, but there's obviously something behind this. And that's an interesting thought that Chris Palmer brought out recently. But how are you getting on with this new interface that Google's wanting you to use? Well, I know many of you are struggling to find everything on it. It's not quite the same as it was before. So I'm just going to show you a couple of things you may be missing. So first of all, notice here that you've got the 7152 views. This is where you now get your stats. So it's easy again to miss it. You could be looking through the menus, you can't find it. If you just click on this, this brings up your new stats. You can see how you're doing. You can then see how your stats are, your keywords, whether you've had messages, whether you've got bookings and so on. And the second thing that you might be missing is you might have gone through all of these other menus. So there's a lot more information you have to click through, and you click through again and you get kind of all these menus and things that come up. But the one thing you may be missing is on these three dots here, because here you've got things like your notifications. So this is another secret menu that the majority of you would have missed if you didn't click on it. So just look out for that. If there's something you can't find here, and if it's not part of what Google's trying to push through to you here, then the chances are the three dots are going to have it in there for you. So for my next one, it's a bit more of a hack really, and it's a way in which Google hasn't really realized that animated GIFs can still exist on products. I've mentioned it a couple of times before. It's something you may want to try. So if you go to your products, it only works on products. I'll show you how I put my logo. So you notice this, this is an animated GIF, but if you try and upload animated GIFs, Google doesn't seem to allow for it at the moment, even though it's got the ability to deal with it. So how do I add a new one? Well, I'm celebrating 10,000 subscribers. So I've got this animated GIF. I'm going to take that and I'm going to rename it to JPG. If I bring that image in as a JPG, because if I now add a product and I select it and I then upload the JPEG, 10,000 YouTube subscribers, because I'm actually having that and I'm giving away 101 tips. So there you go. So the JPEG is actually being converted and understood by Google here so far. Select category. So I'm going to do this as part of my Google My Business SEO. It's a free gift. Product price, so it's going to be free, so it's optional, so I'll just leave that as zero. Product description, so I've just written a small description here, celebrating the 10,000 customers or YouTube subscribers. Add a button, and what we'll do, we'll give them a link through to my YouTube. Click save, take a few seconds to go through, and it's pending. So we might have to come back to that, but there you go, it's starting to show as an animated GIF. We'll see whether that gets accepted in a moment. Now, the next thing that's often referred to is justifications. And you find this when you go to Google Maps, you do a search for something specific. So I'll just show you how this works here. So I've done a search here for relaxed spa days in London. And as I go through the map here, you'll notice then that most of the word relaxed is coming up, or one night relax. And then you get these little icons as well. So this tick here means it's a service that mentions this. So they provide it. You notice here, this would be implying a review. Someone mentions it in a review. And if I go down a bit further here, you'll see their website mentions it, that their website mentions day, spa and relaxation, which ties in with the search terms. Here again, service is ticked here, provides skin treatments. And there are lots of other things as well. If you've got perhaps a restaurant, it might have the menus it refers to. So just notice how external things and reviews and your website and your services all affect the ranking of where you appear in Google My Business or the maps itself. So you notice here that things like spa is the main category, day spa. You only get one category, but there's another secret behind this as well. And you can get this from going to Google Business or GBP audit for local SEO. So I'll put the link down below where you can install a Chrome extension. So I've installed this. Let's just switch this on. So you see here, for example, it just says spa, but click on this. It still says spa, but then it also says day spa, facial spa, massage therapist. So why is this so important? Well, these are hidden. These are secrets that Google haven't given that information out in the results. But with this little tool here, you can get this extra information, which then if that's relevant to your business, then it would make sense that you put that as a secondary category. So before I forget, just go back to Google My Business. Did that work? So the pending's disappeared. There you go. So if I go down to there, you see now it's gone through. And so now if I look at my products, I've now got an animated product here, and I've got this countdown to my 10,000 YouTube subscribers as well. So that shows that those animated JPEGs actually get picked up as animated GIFs. Another little kind of secret that you may not know about, but Google has recently released some information to say that the app itself is going to be done away with. Here in 2022, we'll retire the Google My Business app, so small businesses can take advantage of the upgraded merchant experience on Google Maps and search. So there you go, I've revealed to you really all the things that could easily affect your business. Now, many of you have been saying you've been receiving a large drop in traffic recently, and this is down to the fact that in the last couple of weeks, Google's been releasing some quite strong updates to how local traffic is perceived and how Google My Business or Google Business Profile uses the maps and the local search results. So that's an ongoing thing at the moment. If you're seeing changes in your ranking, that's because the algorithm's just been adapted and changed this week. But what you can do to defeat all these changes is do things the right way. And you can now visit our playlist, which is going to give you over 100 tips for Google Business Profile or Google My Business. So click on it here, and I'll meet you on those videos.